Just once. Hey guys, it's Convolva here, and today we're going to build a beast of a PC with my sister, Sriya. So the reason why we're building this PC is because my sister over here is into video editing, animation and VFX. So I thought this is a good time in the year to build this PC because a bunch of new products came into the market and they all changed the pricing quite a bit. Like this one, this is the RX 5700 XT by AMD. And Sapphire just launched its Pulse Edition, which has this dual fan thing, last month. So we just went and bought the rest of the stuff, and now we're finally going to build your PC, right?
Oh yeah, definitely. Been building on this for how long? A year?
Almost, like we started in April, right? So yeah, been a good 7 months.
Wow.
Wow, I did the math right?
Yeah.
So yeah, 7 months, give or take. And a lot of research went through this, so we just wanted to, you know, compile it all together and, you know, present it in a video so that you guys don't have to go through all this. All that research could actually help in the long run, you know, when some part, you know, stops functioning or you want to upgrade something, so you don't have to take it to the PC service center and spend a lot of money.
You have to spend so much money, so much time, and you don't even have the PC to work on, so there's all the time you're spending without the PC is all the time being lost.
Yeah, that's one of the reasons why I thought it's a good idea to sort of buy individual products and build it on our own. We did not anticipate the amount of time and effort that goes into, you know, doing the research for these products, because man, there's a lot of research.
And it's like especially better if you like build your own PC rather than buy it, because it's a lot cheaper.
Oh yeah, the price, because this entire PC costed us 1 lakh. It is
INR.
1 lakh INR is 100,000 Indian rupees.
Yeah, 100,000.
And that would be somewhere around $100,000. Let me get my phone.
Wait,
Let me get my phone. 100,000 divided by 72. So it comes out to be around $1,388. And we did some research a few months ago when we were building the PC, and we found some PCs by manufacturers, and those PCs costed somewhere north of 8 lakh INR.
Oh, no, it was 899, right?
899. So let me just check how much it is in dollars.
It was expensive.
So 8 lakhs.
No, that's 80. It's bad.
I was doing it right.
Ten thousand.
This is 80,000. Oh yes, my math is bad. Oh right, this number is too big. That's why I got to think.
Yeah, it's 11,000.
Look at this number.
$11,000.
11,000.
This PC from a manufacturer.
11,111. To get it from someone like Dell or HP. At that point we were like, okay, we don't have that much money.
We're broke. Give us money, guys. Patreon right now.
So after we did research for a couple of days, we figured that buying through a big manufacturer is not an option. So we did some research, like any sane individual would do, and we found that building your own PC can be one of the best things that you could do in your life.
Before you die.
Before you die.
Oh, we should name this. The one thing you must do before you die. Build your PC, the experience is amazing. I mean, I've not experienced it yet. But I'm sure it'll be really good.
Yeah, that's what she said.
It's really important to build your own PC at least like once in your life, because we've already talked about how it's the cheaper option, but what we've not talked about yet is the experience of it. Like you can see, we've experienced half of it. We covered some half of it.
Yeah, building the research part and actually figuring things out.
Figuring things out and then going and getting them, and then you go to the shop, you're in the shop, you talk to the guy and you're like, hey, I want this product. I did like 1 month of research behind this. He's like, yeah, I don't have it. Nobody has it, India doesn't have it.
India doesn't have it here, bro. So then we figured out that, oh, there's something called as Amazon, you know, Prime, and you can just get it from different countries, you know?
Yeah.
And then we figured that the custom price is like 8 times the price of the product itself.
I don't know. expensive.
I think that was one of the most interesting parts of the research,
yeah.
Is to figure out what is actually available.
And what is compatible and what you want and if it will fit in your budget all at the same time.
So, what we did was we used the website PC Parts Picker. And this is a website where you can actually check for compatibilities of all the products that
this
you're
video
going to.
Is
let
not
me
sponsored.
Finish my thought.
This video is not sponsored. Continue with your thought.
Yeah. So what we did was we went to this website called as PCPartsPicker.com and we started with our CPU. At that point, we knew that we wanted a CPU which had multiple cores. Could have handled multiple threads.
Yeah.
So we wanted an option which was not only affordable but also had at least 16 threads.
Mm.
So we went and bought this AMD Ryzen 7 1700 as our CPU.
Yeah.
And it has 8 cores and 16 threads. So we bought this, and then after selecting this, we went and found out the motherboard that it could sit on. That is this Tomahawk B450, and it has AM4 slot in which this AMD processor sits on. And then after doing a bunch of pieces, yeah, we have become very simple. So yeah, that's how you build a PC.
Yeah,
the dog's barking.
Alright, so the dog started barking, so now we have to do this lame voiceover thing. But hey, at least the audio quality is a little better now. In this video, I'm just going to show you all the products that we selected for this build. But if you are interested in knowing more, then you should check out this other video that I also posted on the channel, where I go about the products that we selected and why we went with them. So for the CPU, we chose the Ryzen 7 1700, which is an 8-core processor at 3.7 GHz turbo boost speed, which sits on the MSI Tomahawk B450 motherboard. For the GPU, we went with the Sapphire Pulse RX 5700 XT. This is the 8GB overclocked version that Sapphire offers. And for the RAM, we went with 2 sticks of 16GB Corsair Vengeance LPX DIMMs, giving us a total of 32GB of DDR4 RAM at 3200MHz. For storage, we selected a 512GB Samsung 970 EVO NVMe SSD, along with an additional 1TB Seagate Barracuda hard disk, which is all run by a 650 watts power supply by Corsair. We also purchased a TP-Link Archer T6E1300, which is a high-speed PCIe network adapter, as our motherboard did not come equipped with an inbuilt Wi-Fi adapter. And finally, for the case, we went with the white H500 by NZXT. We also added some custom 50-50 RGB LED strips to add some blink to this build. So, with all that said, now let's begin with the build.
Thank you. So you guys must have seen from the B-roll that the PC has started working, it's booted nicely and now it's working properly. So just to be sure, I installed some video editing softwares to see how it performs, and I was freaking amazed by how well this PC performs in comparison to the old PC that I was operating on. I remember what used to take me about a week to perform now only takes me about 5 minutes on the video editing softwares. Which I'm sure you guys can imagine, you know, it's like a huge technological leap for me. Now, whenever I go to the old PC just to do some video editing, it just feels like I'm going back to Stone Age, you know. The entire workflow is now much snappier and more capable than what it was before, you know. Now, I can finally work on multiple projects at once, which is like a huge thing for me. So, for the most part, music production does not take, you know, beefy GPUs and huge hard disk sizes to do any kind of creative work, you know. For video editing, sure, you do need beefy GPUs and, you know, fast CPUs. But as far as music production is concerned, it's a lot more about how you manage your plugins and the stems and how you manage the resources within the project file. Lot more than, you know, how powerful your PC is. So I would still be using my old PC for most of my music production, and that's for two main reasons. The first being that I have already purchased all these softwares and plugins and they are registered on the old PC. So it's just easier for me to transfer all the video work to the new system. Secondly, and in my opinion, this is the more important reason as to why I'm still gonna use the old PC for music production, as because I have always been an advocate of the fact you really don't need a high-end PC to create any kind of good music. I've seen people use really exceptional and high-end PCs to make really shitty and crappy music. And on the other hand, I've also seen people with really, really subpar tools creating awesome music. So it all comes down to how you use the tools and not the tools itself. Sure, it's good to have some really, you know, fast PC or good tools, but that is just going to help you improve your speed of creation, but the creation itself is going to depend on you and your skills. So ultimately, in the end, it's a good thing to have a good system and tools for productivity reasons, but in the end, it all comes down to how you utilize those tools. In my opinion, that's what creates all the difference in the world. But you guys might see me use this new PC from time to time for mixing and mastering purposes or testing out new sound design techniques, you know, sound design research or anything in general which requires a higher CPU power to do. But in general, most of my music production is still going to happen on my laptop because I just think it's also more convenient because now I can carry it around to places and I don't have to just come and sit here in the studio. So that's one of the reasons why I'm still going to work on the laptop. If you guys are planning to get a new PC just for making music, and if you currently have a system which does okay work, then here's a word of advice for you, and take it with a grain of salt because it depends on whatever your needs are at the moment. So just don't, because you probably don't need it anyway. That won't be as helpful as actually working on your skills and music production in general. Alright guys, that's it for today. And if you have any questions about PC building or music production or anything in general, then leave a comment down in the video. And if you have any questions about video editing, then you can check out my sister's channel. She's just starting out on YouTube, and I'll just put the link to her channel in the description box. You guys can check it out. She's also doing a little vlog for the entire build of this PC. So you can see what all went through in the behind the scenes, you know. So yeah. Apart from that, that's it for today. Thanks for watching, and if you feel like I've helped you, then consider hitting the like and subscribe button.